saving us from that man.
No problem.
I'm glad we found you.
Here, take this. I wish I had more to give you, but we don't have much.
Yeah? Oh, thank you for saving Billy. Huh?
Hey.
Go ahead.
Hey, Valentine.
How are we doing on the hunt for Eddie's tapes?
Is this vendetta really worth it, Nick? I mean, you don't even know this guy.
I don't expect you to understand. Heck, I don't need you to. We just need to find those tapes.
Can't go outside and play. All my friends are dead.
Hey.
It's almost there's like something you need? Take a look.
Get some more ammo soon.
I never thought I would see my mom and dad again. Thanks.
Hey.
Where did I put that?
Nick asked for my help in retrieving 10 holotapes belonging to Eddie Winter. He thinks the Commonwealth's police evidence terminals should be able to point me towards the tapes. So, one more.
Take him out!
Start.
What?
Just let me type, dammit. The Scorps. This is useless. We've sent down into the parking lot and killed several of the Scorps that came out, but there seem to be just as many today. We keep killing them, but they keep coming back. If we just keep away from them, they seem to leave us well enough alone. but Clint wants them cleared out of here. Baker rigged up some explosives at the parking lot so I could take a break and get up to camp for a bit. The power armor we found in that church has taken a beating from the scorps, so Baker helped me rig up some better armor for it. I was about to tell him how I feel about him, but the detachment we sent after the settlers showed up kind of lost the mood at that point. God damn it, Clint. I can't fucking believe this. That asshole Clint let those Minutemen get away with the settlers. He says they gave him the slip, but how do we know he isn't playing one side against the other? He betrayed the Minutemen. How can we trust that he isn't betraying us now for a better deal? I still can't believe Captain West gave that asshole the command. Play tape.
Look, Tessa, the orders come down straight from Captain West. Message to Claire Pazinski. Message to Rodrigo Palomar. Message to Buster Conley. Message to Charlotte Wen. Message to Sal Bosconi. Message to Claire Pazinski. Message to Robert Cooper. Message to Johnny Montrano. Message to Alexander Strelnikov. My esteemed Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion above all else. But I have to honestly say, screw that. I mean, come on. One bullet, halfway across town, and you blew Ron Trevio's head clean off. Look, Tessa, the orders come down straight from Captain West. Clint has the command here, and that's just how it is. If you keep running your mouth off, he's gonna make an example of you to show that he's still in charge. And why do you think he picked you to deal with those scorps down at Super Duper Mart? Now, maybe you got away with that shit back when you were running with raiders, but gunners stick to the chain of command. Besides, we wouldn't have been able to take Quincy without him, and you wouldn't have that sweet power armor. So get over it. Baker out.
Or don't make them like they used to.
Mama Murphy. I can't believe Mayor Jackson is actually trying to get the Minutemen out here based on Mama Murphy's drug craze hallucinations. Marcy tried to explain to him that she's just an old loon and we've been refusing to sell her chems anymore. But she's even got Sturgis convinced. Now we're going to have to board and feed a bunch of freeloaders with laser muskets. For nothing in return. Kyle's all excited, and I'm going to have to break it to him that the Minutemen aren't actually like the stories he's heard. She was right. I can't believe it. She was actually right. Sloan and Irma were working, making repairs to the walls, and saw them sneaking around by that old warehouse. We tried to scare them off, but they were still advancing on the monorail stairs. Then just when it looks like they are going to break through, the Minutemen actually showed up and drove them off. They're led by a man named Colonel Hollis, and Kyle is completely awestruck. Said he is going to join them when he gets older, and has been following them around like a puppy. Kyle's hurt. I can't believe this. None of the reinforcements Colonel Hollis promised were on their way have shown up. The gunners have been trying to find a way to get through the wall daily now. To make matters worse, while Kyle was following the Minutemen patrols around, he caught a bolt in the leg. It only nicked a bone, but he's going to have trouble walking. If we can make it through this somehow... Something's up. Something's going on. We thought at first that another of the Minutemen had shown up. Since it seemed like Colonel Hollis recognized him, the two of them went off to talk with Mayor Jackson in private. Yeah, fuck all that. Who cares? Alright.
Electron off.
Message to Charlotte Wen. My dear Miss Wen, I hope you're well. After our little joint venture this past May, you should be. If memory serves correctly, that pallet of buff out earned you a small fortune, and Wu Li 8 years in a state correctional facility. So I got to thinking, why not do it again? We both love the same things, money, and destroying people who get in our way. Together. Message to Alexander Strelnikov. My esteemed Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion. honestly say. Screw that. Message to Alexander Strelnikov. My esteemed Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion above all else. But I have to honestly say, screw that.
Heads up.
So, you got something for me? Maybe a pocket full of tapes belonging to an old ghoul?
What was it we were looking for again?
10 tapes recorded by that hooligan Eddie Winter. Word is, they got stashed in police departments around the Commonwealth. When you find them all, you bring them to me.
Finally got them all. Here.
No fooling. Wow. That's some real solid detective work. They're older than dirt, but they've got Eddie's paw prints all over them. These are the real deal. And they've still got the code pieces in them. Let me run them through the old processor. Got it. 1-9-5-3-7-2-8-4-0-6. That old thug's holed up in Andrew's station. Now, let's go bring down Eddie Winter. Someone's coming.
You don't have to do this.
Seriously, you know that?
got him.
Ha ha!
bow.
This is an emergency message to all Commonwealth Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect. If you are in distress, please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint for aid. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook. Checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition. This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety. This message will repeat. This is an emergency message to all Commonwealth Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect. If you are in distress, please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint for aid. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook. This checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition. This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety. This message will repeat.
You'll run out of bullets at some point.
Who's there? Who?
Shook up a bit.
Sure as hell looks that way.
Someone there?
What the?
What you got left in you?
Got it.
Let's not keep Eddie waiting.
Huh? What the?
All right. Hey, I thought I saw something.
Not exactly subtle, man.
Just getting warmed up over here.
Protectron on duty. Protect and serve.
Something out there.
Look who it is.
What's that?
That's it.
Lights out for you. That's one way to get that cool one pumping. I can't wait to see the look on what's left of Eddie's face when we pop that lock of his. Filthy toads right on the other side of that door. Why don't you do the honor?
Sure. 1953728406.
The fuck? Who the fuck are you?
Who the fuck am I? Who the fuck are you?
I'm Eddie Winter, and you're in my bunker. Just how the fuck did you get... No. No way. Not after all this time. Don't tell me you actually cracked my code. In the holotapes? Well, hey. It's only been, what? 200 years? Well, look. I'm not sure what you thought you'd find. Gold, jewels... The secrets of the universe. But you get me. One guy. A ghoul, I guess you'd call me. Just living, surviving, and what I got, you can't have. That code? It was a joke. I just wanted to prove how dumb those feds were. Turns out, pretty dumb. So take your asses someplace else.
I'm not going anywhere until I get what I came for.
Yeah? And what's that? And who are you, huh? You look kind of familiar. But, what are you, some kind of robot? Is that what it's like out there now? A world of robot overlords? I knew it.
The name's Valentine. Nick Valentine. Remember me?
Valentine? The cop? Is that who you're supposed to be? Sorry, pal, but you ain't Nick Valentine. You're just some kind of, machine.
You killed my fiance, Jennifer Lance. Some crimes even you can't get away with.